pinaloob namin ang ating VIP card. At so, pag-register nyo, madala ang VIP card. So, automatic, meron tayong eco bag. So, ayan. So, ano bang meron dito sa Food Expo? So, samahan nyo ako guys. Pasok tayo sa
Wow, ang lutong, brother.
Yes.
niya is
air fry.
Air fry.
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. Galing, ha? Okay. Hindi masyadong maano, no? Mapait yung garlic.
Hindi po, ma'am.
Hindi sarap.
Bili ka na, ma'am. For 2,000 pesos only.
Ikot muna ako, ha?
Sige po,
check natin yung mga price. Galing. Akala ko pasta talaga. Sample lang pala.
Okay.
Thank you. Mixer.
African bean, probably sa Malaysia. Ang brand ko, favorite cocoa. Makakabili po sa chocolate lover sa All About Baking.
Mm.
Okay.
Tibay, di ba, ma'am?
Hindi siya nalulusaw na ano.
Ayun, 2 days na yun, no?
2 days? Oh. Simula nung ano?
Talaga?
Recently pa natin. Ito, ganito. Ang cute nito, ah.
Ito, ito.
Picture lang ko, ah. Ang ganda, eh. Frozen or kailangan frozen dapat bago i-whip? Ah, tow muna ng konti. Hmm, okay. Matamis or mataba? Ah, ano? Pwede tikman? Thank you. Mm. Ilang hours yung standby niya bago matunaw?
2 days, ma'am.
2 days bago siya matunaw? Ah. Ang galing, ah.
Marami pa ng bali.
Yung temp niya, basta kailangan
malamig.
Malamig naman. Okay.
Kailangan bibili.
Ang galing, ah. Amaze naman dito. Silver. Magkano yung ganito? 200 yung sambax. 200 daw, isang piraso. Okay. Saan siya nabibili? Available na sa? Dito lang. Bulacan kami. May kawayan. Mga supermarket, available siya. Ay, ganon. Okay. Thank you. Ganda. Okay.
Pagkita.
Kuchay?
Yes. Ito madamo.
Ay, thank you.
Ano siya madamo?
Ay, wow. Magkano yung ganyan?
235 madam.
235?
Yes.
Available siya sa... Mga supermarket, gano'n? Ay, gano'n? Ah, okay. Ah, Landers, meron. Ah, okay. Akala ko ang Earthsouth, ang ano lang. Parang pearl.
Ay, yung mga...
Oo, parang... Oo, yung mga milty-milty.
Ay, yung mga restaurant.
Ah, okay. Oo.
Ang marapian mo, dapat higit ka rin ako. Bukang masabi, pearl.
Bukang pa.
Wow!
Galing isa pa?
Galing isa pa. Kapiyan mo eh. Sarap
eh. Madam! Okay, sarap.
Ayaw naman ka ate. Gusto niya ba yung buo? Tiga, tiga. Madam! Ito ka na? Ito yung dalawang
buo. Thank you! Sarap.
Ano ma'am? Packaging materials?
Ah, mga packaging materials. Ganun. Hi guys, kasama ko si Ate Dada. Ayan. Uy, may pa-promote ka, diba? Promote ka, Dada. Yung ano yung...
Ah, sa Bicol ko, dito malaki.
Ah, Bicol ba? Ayan, so ayan.
One six
ang pamasahe ka, dito. Yung, uy, may airsaw, airsaw. May nakita ko airsaw dun, ah. Ayaw nga pala, sorry. Ay, sige. Ay, picture muna.
This is one of the so-called automatic labyrinthine machines. They are another new model as well. So what benefits does an automatic labyrinthine bring to us? First of all, you can see we have actually programmed already the so-called sheathing cycles. When I say sheathing cycle is, as a baker, as a professional baker, you may know better than me. Depending on the type of dough, we can actually program the dough to be sheeted down according to the number of cycles that you want. Meaning to say that we can start from a certain given thickness of the dough and within a few muscles sheet it down to the thickness you want. Or we can do it very gently, small step every time, which is very gently to step down to sheet down the dough to the final thickness. This all depends on your requirement as well as the different kind of dough. So in this instance here, we are actually compressing the Poisson dough. The information, this Poisson here, the Poisson dough here, is 27 layers. So it is actually three times of the senior hole. So this 27 layers of the Poisson dough is now fitted to a setting of 3.2 millimeters. So we have finished with the sheeting process. So now we are going to actually flip this piece of Poisson dough into the so-called medium-sized Poisson machine of Rondo of Switzerland. So the first process that we will go through is so-called a calibrator or gauging unit. The calibrator is set to catch the dough further to 43 millimeter. Because again, whether it's 3 millimeter or 43 millimeter, that depends on the requirement again. Yeah? So but in this instance here, we are gauging it down to 3 millimeter. Do you see the moving up and down roller over here? Look, as the dough goes by the practice in the center, you can see. Do you know what it's a function for? Anyone? This is actually so-called relaxer. So it is just meant to simulate when we manually prepare the dough. We just want to relax the dough. It's a small thing, but it is important for preserving good quality dough structure. We always say, rubbish in and rubbish out. If we are able to make sure that the dough is always in the best condition, only then we'll be able to make sure the best one is in this product. So, after going through the so-called cutting unit, now we come to the cutting station. In the cutting station, we have a so-called length cutter. The length cutter is where we cut the height of the cutter. And then the plastic guide is there to actually cut out the dough.
Sa halaga ngayon, ito na halos kita sa SO. May sa namin ka naman tikman dito.